You understand? That's why I gave you, it's the 3x, the derivative this one, same thing, but we multiply the derivative this one with respect to x, which is 3. So this is exactly the same again. So we find the derivative with respect to v, that we have same form, it's the u plus v, times the derivative of the power with respect to v, not u, v. Let's move to y direction. So let's find the partial derivative of this one with respect to y. Will be 2xy, right?
Yeah.
So this is 0. So we have 2xy. That's my partial derivative with respect to y. Then we move to y value, find the partial derivative with respect to v again. So what is it? Tell me.
1.
dy dv. dy dv what?
1.
1? Okay, this one becomes 1, but there is a product of u, what is it?
0.
U
no, u times 1.
Before you speak, please think.
U times 1, yeah.
Please! The solution is not already 0, okay? Or not 1.
Really, if you overlook the sign, you mess up.
Again, what's the derivative? Partial derivative this with respect to v.
U.
Thank you, u. This is a constant times v, right?
Yep.
The derivative of v is 1, so u times 1 is u. Good. So we're done now. So now we have to evaluate x and y, right? At u equal to 1, v equal to 3. Let's plug in u equal to 1, 3. U equal to 1, v equal to 3, right? So this will be x will be e to the 1 plus 3, u plus v, it will be e to the 4, that's my x value. Y will be u times 4, which is 1 times 3, right? It will be 3. So this is y, what my x and y at this point, 1, 3. So let's plug in. 9 minus 1 over e to the 4. I plug x and y. E to the u plus v, let's plug in 1 and 3 in u, v will be 4. Good? Plus x and y, what was x? E to the 4 and 3. So it becomes 6 times e to the 4. What was u? U was 1. This is my solution. So let's simplify. We have 9 times e to the 4 minus 1, because this will be canceled out. And we have 6 e to the 4. The solution will be 15 e to the 4 minus 1. This is my final solution. Let's do one more, the last one. Number 10. We have to evaluate du dx, right? Du dx. At 1, 2, 3, 1. My u function is given by p square, q square. So they said u, p, q, r function, right? So p square minus q square minus r. And my p is given by xy, and q is given by y square, r is given by x times g. So they play a little bit different, so they use a different letter for this problem, but the idea is the same as what we did in previous. One of the problem will be about using chain number 3, I think. Number 4? I don't remember. Number 3 or number 4?
Wait, what do you mean?
I'm doing the test number 2.
You're going to ask us something similar to it?
Is it AZ? Or is it AZ? So, number 1, question number 1 will be finding partial derivative, right?
Mm-hmm.
Question number two will be finding more partial derivative.
Like first,
more order.
Like first and second order.
Second or third, of course.
Okay.
Let's remember how to do that.
I can get it.
And then third order will be partial derivative using chain rule. Fourth will be partial derivative. Let's say partial implicit method. Maybe five international derivative.
You said five words, what?
Huh?
You said five words?
Directional derivative.
Okay.
Maybe this is outline. I think I can modify a little bit, but it is based on this, you know, the homework problem. So let's look at it. So we have to find du dx, right? So we have to find this one with respect to x. Okay. This one is our x, y, t, and this p, q, r function, right? So we have three different directions, p, direction, q, direction, r direction. But see, exactly the same. So let's put u, p, partial derivative this one with respect to p, right? Time, move to p, then dp, dx. We couldn't find the x value. So again, so when you multiply the product at the end, we have to have the same letter. So we have same letter, right? When you multiply, we have the same letter when you multiply. But this is for x direction, y direction, and multiply the binary for t with respect to this one. So with respect to x. But this is PQR, not XYZ function. This is PQR. That's why you find partial derivative this one with respect to P first. So we're done in the P direction. Let's move to Y, R, Q direction, right? U, Q, and then Y. Q direction is this one, DQ, DX, right? Plus, last one, U, R, and DR, DX. This is my partial derivative using chain rule. So let's get UP, the derivative, this one with respect to P, just 2P, 2 times P. And DP dx will be Y. And we done P direction. Now let's move to Q direction. Partial derivative, this one with respect to Q, will be
2Q.
Minus 2Q. And move to this, dq dx, what is dq dx?
2y.
2y, you sure? dq dx, partial derivative, this one with respect
oh, zero.
To x.
That would be 0.
Yeah, let me check because there is no x here. Only y value, y constant in expression, right? Good. So you are, the derivative, this one with respect to r, what is that?
1.
You won? Okay. Think more. What is the partial derivative of this one with respect to r?
1.
Negative 1.
Negative 1.
See, I thought a little bit this time, I think.
What's dr dx now?
0.
What's dr dx?
Z.
Please, careful. So again, we have to evaluate. When x equals to 2, y equals to 3, and g equals to 1, right? But I don't know what p, q, r, they have it. Let's plug in 2, 3, and 1. X equals to 2, y equals to 3, and g equals to 1.
Wait, is that a up? Up times?
Yeah, up. Partial derivative with respect to p of u function. I know. He moved to round 8. Yeah. Korean player, tennis player, he moved to round 8.
And you're like a proud father over there.
Yeah, so proud.
You say he moved to what?
Because
now?
I'm like to watch him like a sport.
Yeah.
If Korean, even absent, you know, country, Korean is, you know, like performing like a different, like one of the top players, then we cheer up. Like, try to keep watching.
That's like when Serena.
Like a white cup, right?
Yeah, like Serena always wins, like Wimbledon.
Serena?
Serena Williams, like the tennis.
Oh, yes, yeah, yeah.
I'm about to say, you play, watch tennis, you don't know Serena Williams.
The Vanessa Williams, I know Vanessa Williams,
but. Yeah. It's like you know she's gonna win, like, she's just dominant.
Mm-hmm. I don't get it, right? Oh, the players. I love it. because I'm playing tennis, that's why I know the rule.
Yeah, so, yeah, you get
really I got more hyper.
Do you like doubles or just singles?
Singles. I like the playing double, but you know, it's very hard to you know, collect the people.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
We need at least to move four people, right? Like,
my double. Favorite thing is like when you get a good serve and you get that nice spin off and that nice fight. Mm-hmm. And, yeah.
But double is more fun. I know that. And you know, I don't adjust you know easily because of double. But single because you know I love single because you know I practice more workout.
Yeah.
Which to you know lose my weight.
Yeah.
So yeah, I play the tennis for now 10 years. I love it.
You have a tennis club you go to?
I got a win. Round the semi-final in the Atlanta, Alta. You know what Alta is?
No,
I'm not. Atlanta Tennis Association.
Really?
Yeah, I played. I got a the semi-final over there.
That's what's up, Professor?
You know, from Atlanta. But I really love
it. Is it expensive?
What do you mean expensive?
No, like your club dues and all that stuff.
It's not a club. I just, you know, register.
Uh-huh.
Then I got a win with my team. So I joined double.
Yeah. And
not single. Single I cannot do that. But double, if you are lucky, then you can win. Because only the problem is body, in the front guy.
Yeah.
If you have a good body skill,
yeah,
then you will win. The body is most important in double. But single, oh shit, you have to get all technique to win in single game. Well, I don't have a good technique though.
So. You ever try golf? You like it?
Yeah, I like it. So let's look at it, by the way. So we have to evaluate PQR at this point, right? So my P will be 2 times 3, X times Y, will be 6, right? And Q will be Y squared, this is the Y value, 3 squared will be 9, and R, X times G, 2 times 1, will it be 2? So we have a P 6, Q 9, R 2, X equal to 2, Y equal to 3, G equal to 1. So now it's time to plug in. So 2 times P is given by 6. And Y is given by 3. Okay? So this one becomes 0 because we multiply 0, it's garbage. And then this one is minus 1 times G. G is given by 1, right? So it'd be minus 1. So 2 times 36 minus 1, 35. This is my answer. So let's move to higher order differential and derivative, partial derivative. So any question in chain rule? So far, so good?
Yeah, so far, another question going back. Did I do? I mean, I got all the correct answers, but did I do this the way you want?
I can't see you now. But, you know, only this problem, I think. And increased derivative, right?
Yeah, because, like, the first order, I'm talking about like, the first order and, like, the second order like, problems. Do you care if you write the.
For the chain rule?
No, for the first and second order. Because I wrote mine like this, with the f of x and the y.
Yeah.
Okay.
So now let's look at this function. F is given by, let's say, sine x, y, g. I like to evaluate you guys, f of x, y, g. Okay? Let's say vector x, y, g. How was it? Can you do that? So this is one of the problem. So to get this one, the first step we have to evaluate x. Again, the way, the order is from moving from left to the right, right? Mm-hmm. So let's find f of x first. The derivative of this with respect to x will be cosine x, y, z, because sine changed to cosine, right? Time to chain rule. The derivative is inside with respect to x. What is it?
Yg.
Yg, thank you, yg. This is my first partial derivative. Now let's move to second partial derivative. X and y, right?
Yep.
This will be second. It means we have to find derivative this with respect to y. Takes more time because we have to apply product. We have 2y. So the derivative of cosine minus sine, x, y, z, multiply, derivative inside with respect to y will be x times g, right? But there is y, g, let's plug in y, g. Plus, and derivative this part with respect to y will be g, right? Y times g, the derivative with respect to y will be g, right? 1 times g will be g. Cosine, x, y, g, we don't change it, but we have to multiply g. How was it? That make sense?
Yep.
Now, let's simplify. This will be minus x, y, g squared sine x, y, g. I think I did too much. And g times cosine x, y, g, right? Now let's move to the last problem. We have to find, finally, x, y, g. Means we have to find the derivative of this one with respect to g. Be careful, we have a g times g, g times g. We have to use product rule 2 times. Let's do the first one, minus 2xyg, the derivative of g squared 2 times g. That's why we have minus 2 times g with xy, and sine xyg, plus, but there is minus, minus xy. G squared times derivative of this with respect to g. So we have a cosine x, y, g times derivative of inside with respect to g will be x, y. So we finish the first one. Then we move to second. Again, we have to apply product rule one more time. The derivative of this one with respect to g is just 1, right? 1 times cosine x, y, g plus g times the derivative of this one with respect to g. So cosine will change negative sign. So it changes to negative sine x, y, g. The derivative again inside will be x times y. So this is my partial derivative.
Was this something? What, that,
was not.
Oh, okay. Oh, just one question. Why did you do it like, f of x, so wait,
we
did
it
f of x, y.
So, I may change the question, find f, g, y, x. The first step is what? Finding partial derivative with respect to what?
Z.
Z, thank you. The order is from the left to the right. Your starting point will be f, g, and then move to f, g, y, move to finally f, g, y, x.
Why couldn't you do f of...
That negative z, shouldn't it be 1 over there for the last one, the z sine, x, y?
No, this is
1
times x, y. This is derivative inside with respect to g.
When you did that one, why not do f of y? Why did you do f of x, y?
Okay, my goal is to find this one.
Okay.
I cannot start from f of y. Why? Start from x. Then we have to find the second derivative of y with respect to y from f of x function. We keep updating data to get our final solution. This is our final solution, by the way.
Yeah. So you say for the f of x, you're finding the first order, right?
Right, because you start from f of x.
And then the second order for y?
Y with this function.
Yeah. So you started from that function. And you say that the derivative of cosine is negative sign.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, you say you
the derivative is inside with respect to y.
Maybe
x times g.
Yeah.
But why j is here?
Oh,
it's a product rule again.
Yeah,
it's a product rule.
So wait, why did you bring the because it's a y z.
Mm-hmm.
But with respect, then how come you didn't take that y away then?
What do you mean by it?
Isn't it?